you have been in this game for some time now. How would you rate the performance of the art industry in general?
I mean, I've been actively in the creative art for the past 15 years, right? And I'm one of those who feel that the creative arts holds one of the potentials to unlock opportunities for us, but also to use the creative arts as an opportunity to develop the way the country and the continent moves. Because I always say that the arts is the last frontier. If artists fail, Africa has failed. You know, and I'm proud, for example, when I use Nigeria as an example, everybody has failed in Nigeria, in quotes, except the artists. The artists who are holding the flag of Nigeria high, the writers, the musicians, the actors, and all of that, right? So art is really important if you can harness its power, both for economic gain as well as for cultural and, you know, national emancipation. And I think that gradually that awareness is seeping in the last couple of years. There's been a lot of advocacy right now. Whenever a government is giving its speeches, budget, you know, State of the Nation address, there's a little bit of mention of the creative arts there. Obviously, there's still a lot to do. We need grand visions, but we need even grand investment to create products that we can take to the rest of the world. And that's what some of us want to do. We are tired of the limitations of our market, of the limitations of the opportunity here. We believe in the talent. We believe in the culture. We believe in the creativity. So what we're asking ourselves is that how can we put all of this together in big, daring, audacious projects for the global market? And that's what some of us have now set our sights for, beyond Ghana. But Ghana is always going to be our base.
So if you were to mention just one magic factor to pushing this art to where we want it to be, what would that be?
Patrons, right? If you look at all around the world, you know, the way art and sciences move is when people are able to invest, put money in foundations. And I mean, when the likes of Rockefeller and Carnegie made their money, they built music halls and did all sort of endowment for arts and education. That's one thing we lack here. We don't have champions, right? So we need to begin a conscious process to build champions for the arts. So this generation will not get them because they are used to a particular way. But for our generation, that's my advocacy now. When some of us become mature and we become leaders and we get into resources, are we going to continue the same vicious cycle? How are we going to measure wealth? Is it going to be in the number of cars and houses that you accumulate, or the impact that you have in your society by using your wealth as a catalyst for growth in various ways? So the one thing that we need in Africa, that we need in Ghana, are champions, patrons of the earth, people who are not afraid to spend to push concepts, whether it's music, it's theater. You know, we need champions, and I hope that we can raise that in our generation.
Great. Now, for the past week, we've been talking about some of our old veteran actors and musicians who are begging for help to pay their rents and all that. I'm sure you've heard some of these stories. And I don't know, do you foresee the industry changing from this narrative, or you think that this might repeat itself some time to come?
I mean, I hope not. I think that now people are more... should I say smart, you know, when you look at let's take music, for example, the likes of Sarkodie, Shatawale, Stormboy, they know that if they don't put their acts together, I mean, they will become paupers in the future. Look at what Yvonne Nelson is doing, you know. So there's an entrepreneurial spirit that is creeping into creative arts. In fact, I say that some of the biggest entrepreneurs we have in this country are people in the creative arts, but we just usually don't like to think of the creative art as entrepreneurs. So I think that the youth now are more aware. We are now in a digital age. Information is in our bounds. So in terms of individually, I'm sure individually people may be putting in effort, making investments, so that when they are no longer on top, they still have, you know, leverage. You know, what I don't know for sure is whether institutionally we are building, you know, the right structures for institutions, so that at least the vast majority of people, whether they are musicians, they are actors or whatever, can still find opportunities after they retire. That's one thing that we have to do. Maybe the financial sector can even be bold to respond to this, right? The insurance company can say, okay, we're creating a special product for people in the creative arts business. You know, those of us in the creative art business, we don't have monthly incomes, for example, that you say, oh, every month we are going to take an amount and put into savings. But if our financial institutions can be smart and develop insurance products that suit the kind of work that people in the creative arts do, the kind of, you know, intermittent way in which we receive, you know, our monies, so that even if it's like a yearly premium or every 6 month premium, but I think that there's opportunity for the financial industry to respond to the needs of people who are not in regular monthly kind of employment, right? So if that happened, then from an institutional point of view, we know that at least some efforts are being made to help people within the creative art at least be able to save, you know, for the future. But individual, I think that young people are now more smart and more aware of the realities, especially with all of these examples that we're seeing. if you are a young person in the creative arts and you are seeing these examples and you are not looking sharp, as we like to say in pidgin parlance, and you find yourself in this same situation, then maybe you may have yourself to blame. But of course, I also acknowledge that some people try all their best, but the opportunities are not there for sustainable income. So we are hoping that once we begin to elevate the place of the creative arts, once there are more investments, once people patronize, once the business of creative arts is really much more developed, then the higher people's incomes, the more they can dispose of some for, you know, how do you call it, insurance and into pensions.
Thank you.